Today, I'm going to show you how to animate a still image in Photoshop by using some simple techniques. The result is very similar to the Plotograph effect, and if you're not familiar with it, you can check out plotographs.com where you can find amazing photo animations. It's really impressive how you can bring your photo to life using this method, so if you're excited about the video, hit the like and let's start the tutorial. Here we are in Photoshop, and if you want to download this amazing photo to follow along with me, the link is down in the description. And before starting this tutorial, what do you think about this new trend of animating still images? Leave a comment below. So, make sure that you have the image set as a background layer, and the first thing I'm gonna do is to select the crop tool and set the aspect ratio. And I will go with a 16:9. After I crop my image, I also want to resize it to 1920x1080. This is just to work faster, and it's also a good resolution if you want to use the final animation on Facebook, Instagram, or any HD video project. Next, I will enable the quick selection tool by pressing on Q or by clicking on this icon. I hit B for the brush, choose a 50% hardness and a medium size brush, and then paint over the image on the parts that I want to animate. The selection doesn't have to be perfect from the first time because I will refine it after the animation is ready. When I finished painting over the clouds, I hit Q once again and Photoshop will create my selection, but I will need to invert it, so I go to select and choose inverse, and now only the clouds are selected. With the active selection, I press on Ctrl J to duplicate it on a new layer. I hold down the Shift and move this selection to the left because I want to make some room for the movement of the clouds. This layer is now out of the frame on the left side, so I will stretch it back until I reach the right margin of the photo. And just to make it more clear for you, I extended this layer so that I can move it to the right in the next step. I go to Window, activate the Timeline panel, and I click on the Create Video Timeline. I want to have a 2-second animation, so I adjust my work area accordingly. I'm doing the same thing with the clouds layer, and I make sure to activate the loop option by clicking on this wheel and checking the loop playback option. Great, now I can create some keyframes. I make sure that my cursor is at the beginning of the sequence. I click on this arrow here and add a position keyframe at the start. You can see it here, it's like a yellow diamond. I grab the cursor, bring it to the end of the sequence, and add another position keyframe. Now I hold down Shift and use the right arrow on the keyboard to move the clouds layer. And I move it just until the left side of the layer reaches the margin of the photo. So I made the movement of the clouds. I hit the space bar to start the animation. It looks good, but when it's looped and it jumps back to the start, it's very harsh, so I need to fix that. The only way to fix this is to add at least 2 more clouds layers to make this animation much smoother. So first, I would like to duplicate the clouds layer. But if I do that right now, you can see that, first of all, it creates a long layer on the timeline. And secondly, it doesn't duplicate the keyframes from the previous clouds layer. However, there's a nice trick to solve this. Let me undo some steps, and with the layer selected, I press Ctrl plus G to group this layer. Now, when I duplicate it, the new group layer is the same size as the original one, and also, if I open the group, I can see the keyframes like on the previous clouds layer. I drag the second layer to the right until I reach exactly the half length of the layer below. Then I go to Transitions, drag the fade effect and place it on the first half of the second layer. You can see that the sequence just became longer than 2 seconds, but I will fix that in the next step when I will adjust the loop to be seamless because I still have a hard jump to the start here and it doesn't look good at all. I make sure the second group is selected, press again Ctrl plus J to duplicate it, open the group and add again the fade transition, but this time on the second half of the layer. After this step, I can click on the fade transition from the first half and hit delete because I don't need that. To make the loop seamless, I push the third layer backwards and make sure it ends at the 1 second mark. This way, it will play only from the second half and it will fade out. Also, I reposition the end of the sequence at the 2 second mark. Now, the second layer will fade in and play only until the half of it, and then the animation will jump to the start where the layer plays from the half to the end, and this will make my animation seamless. Let's hit play. I have a seamless loop now. The animation looks good, the clouds look good as well. Now, you can have some weird parts during the animation, like these ones for example. You usually see this when the animation jumps back to the start of the sequence. How can you fix those parts? Very simple. You select the background layer, you make a duplicate with Ctrl-J, and you position it above all the layers. It needs to be layer number one. So, you take the layer in the timeline, you drag it to the start of the sequence, and you adjust the end of it to stop at the 2 seconds mark. With the layer selected, hold down Alt and add a negative layer mask. Hit B to choose the brush, make sure white is selected as the foreground color, and start painting on the areas that don't look good when the animation is looping. This is not a hard step at all, and it should be made just because small details always make a big difference in the end. And if you want to be a professional editor, you need to take care of the small details, right? So, this is how the final animation looks like. I think it's pretty good, and it's a fun way to bring photos to life. Make sure you give a like on this video, subscribe if you aren't already for more cool photo and video editing tutorials. I'm Chris, have an awesome day, and see you next time.